spent a lot of time making the decision. So I'm not going to go into any more of it. A lot, though. A lot of time.
How did practice look today?
Pretty good. Practiced well today. Today was a good day.
What over these couple of days, what are you specifically looking to see with Chad now that he's taking the first team reps?
It isn't the first time he's been taking reps, and it isn't the first time he's been taking them behind the first team. We only have one team out there right now, so anytime he comes into practice or came into practice, he's usually behind the first group. So the difference is his reps are higher right now. And I think that what you're looking to see there when you're looking at him and you're watching him there is just the consistency and the rhythm of what it is that you feel his strengths are. And I think that that is, those are some of his strengths. In other words, his rhythm, his consistency, the way he throws the ball with location, those type of things. And that's what I'm judging.
You said you're looking for him to maybe give you a spark. Do you see that on the practice field at all when he's kind of running the show a little bit?
I always see a spark when Chad's in there, yeah. So I've been pretty consistently. He's got a lot of energy. I think one of the things he's done a tremendous job of this year is in understanding his role, you know, up till now, is that, and it wasn't easy for him, obviously, because he wasn't playing, you know, but was to bring that kind of energy to practice. And what is most interesting is to see people still respond to that, even though he wasn't the starting quarterback.
Brandon reminded us earlier that when he first got here, Chad was pretty much the first guy he worked with. He worked out with out of St. Thomas.
Right.
How much of a benefit would that be in when they're...
I think it's a big benefit. I mean, I think that those guys, you know, they spent an awful lot of time together during the course of the summer. But more importantly, I think, you know, in the course of practice over the last several weeks, you know, Brandon run a route or two, but Henny would still be in. Brandon come off. Well, who's he talking to? I mean, when he wants the quarterback's opinion, he's immediately talking to Pennington. So, you know, there's dialogue between Pennington and Brandon, Pennington and Bess, Pennington and Hartline, Ronnie and Ricky and Pennington. I mean, that's happening every time they come off the field and the other quarterback is still out there. No different than the last couple days when they walk off and Pennington's in there. It's now Henny giving them that information. So,
with Randy Starks, obviously, you know, you got pretty much a body of work for half a season at two different positions. Are you getting the kind of productivity that you would have expected out of him coming off last year's fairly productive season?
Well, I wouldn't say that he's – I would say it's been 75-25 probably that he's been playing more end than he's been playing nose. So I don't know if it's been kind of half and half. In other words, Odrick, would Odrick go down the second game? So at that point, that move was really made. Randy does go in there for a little bit, but if you were really counting plays, I mean, it would be minimal that he was actually at nose as opposed to being at end. I would tell you that Randy's production in the last three games, I would say, has picked up tremendously. You know, in the ball game the other day, made a lot of plays from the backside, you know, several plays from the backside. Has had some really good pass rushes out there, so I've seen his production improve in the last couple games. Maybe early on because we were bouncing him around so much, I think that you may not have felt him as much in some of those situations. But, you know, once we settled him down, we started to feel Randy again.
Do you think that that's all it is, him just settling into one spot, one place that will allow him to get back into a groove?
Yeah, I definitely do. I mean, I think, first of all, studying your opponent and who you're playing against, I think when you're studying three different guys in there, that makes it a little bit more difficult. And then I also think that, you know, the right and the left-handed stances, those kind of things that those guys operate from, I think makes it a little bit more difficult too. So by settling him down, I think it gives him a chance to kind of concentrate a little bit more on who he's playing against and those techniques.
Thank you.
there a rookie kick returner, Mariani, or is he somebody who maybe was on your radar? Or what's
the Montana? We knew about him, yeah, because, you know, I mean, we've had some success with the Montana guys, and our scout out there, Adam Ingroff, does a great job in that area out there. So we were able to, you know, to know a lot about him. And
why is he making the impact? I guess he's...
Well, I mean, first of all, the guy is fast. I think he can run pretty well, and I think he's a little bit fearless. You know, I mean, he kind of he's seen that on college tape. You know, he's a little bit fearless there and made a lot of big plays for that football team. So I think those are good qualities to have when you're back there as a return.
Tennessee is 24th in yards per game and first in scoring.
Yeah.
Is it all takeaways that accounts for bridging that gap?
They have 18 of them or thereabouts, and the thing that they're doing with them, which they did against us last year in our game, you know, we turned it over four times and only dug two of them out in that game. I think we threw three interceptions and we fumbled once, and they turned them into points, you know, and that's what they're doing right now. I mean, they're second in the league in turning those turnovers into points, so you give them the football. And they find a way to get it down the other end. You know, when you look at where they are from that standpoint and where we are, hey, in other words, we're minus whatever it is now, 7 or 4 in turnovers right now. But we've taken it away from our opponent one of the fewest amount of times. I think us and maybe one other team are kind of down there. And we have not turned it over into points. We've only scored two of those, you know, 7 or 8 turnovers. So that would be a big point in this game. If you look at their last 10 wins and or losses and you split them up and you put all the critical factors out there, the yardage, all those things look kind of the same. I mean, passing yards, all those things, third downs look really the same. The glaring thing is turnovers. When they win, they get 3 of them. When they lose, they only dig one of them out.
I mean, how many special teams was Jason L. playing on at the end, and who's replacing him?
Yeah, I kind of don't want to say who's replacing him, but it would be more than one guy. And he played on about 2.5 teams. You know, I mean, in the past, Jason was a 4 guy, but we found some guys that can do a few other things, and then he was playing a little bit more. And then when we brought him back, you know, we used him part-time as a gunner. And that's where the half team was, you know, as far as that went. So we kind of used him more on going in punts than we did anything else, because he was pretty good at finding the ball and being able to cover some of those things that way. So, you know, there'll be 3 or 4 guys there that will share that gunner role a little bit, and then a couple guys that will do some of his other jobs.
Tony, what did you guys do so well with Chris Johnson last year? He had just over 100 yards.
Yeah, I think one of the things is that we tackled pretty well in this football game last year, okay? And I do think that when the first person got to him, we had pretty good converge on the football there. I mean, there was guys running to the ball in this game last year against him, and I think the edges of the defense were set pretty good. He only kind of surrounded us, you know, and got outside of us rather a time or two there, and then we got people to the football. So we minimized the long runs in that game, and, you know, I think at the line of scrimmage kind of got him to break down a little bit before he got going. What you don't want to do is just let this guy get his shoulder square.
Happen when they make a schedule, and what's your take on it?
I'm out of answers on what's supposed to happen. But I would tell you that, you know, it is the second time, and we're here in whatever, you know, week 9 right now. And, you know, I'm sure sounds to me like they got pretty good rest. So that's positive for them, I guess. So, you know, but, excuse me?
Cincinnati.
Yeah, Cincinnati as well.
So, yeah,
third in a row.
Been a while. So. Right. Chicago plays this week, though.
Dumb.
Some light at the end of the tunnel.
How does that Thursday game affect your preparation? You got two a real short turnaround.
Yeah, it affects us. I mean, it obviously affects us, but quite a bit. You know, affects the players quite a bit. You know, we'll make sure. One of the things I think you got to do a good job of is the treatment end of things. You know, we'll treat him right there at the stadium post game, and then be here bright and early in the morning on Monday treating him. And you know, and then we got to be smart with our practices. But from a preparation standpoint, the coaches, you know, normally a Friday of a home game, well, you get to go out and, you know, be able to get home early and see your family, and then Saturday, that type of deal. But, you know, we won't do that. We'll spend Friday and Saturday here as long as we need to be here and get some work done. Now, the good news, you know, is that it is a home game, where last year it was an away game for us. So that time at the other end, meaning Wednesday-ish, you know, we can maximize some of that time between Wednesday and Thursday morning, too.
Is Pennington a guy who can help with that transition, help kind of?
Yeah, I think, you know, first of all, just the guy's probably played in, you know, 15 of these things, I would imagine, in his career at some point, you know, these Thursday games. And, you know, and I would also think that from a mental standpoint, when you're crunching preparation, you know, sometimes the thought is, well, let's not try to do a whole lot here. Some people even repeat what they've done, you know, but, you know, with Chad, I think he'd probably do a little bit more.